So, what are invasive species? Non-native specimens are plants, animals, or diseases that have been moved by humans into an outside area of their natural range. Here, they escape into the wild where they reproduce and spread, resulting in significant negative impacts on the environment, economy, and human health. It's important to note that not all native species that are introduced are invasive, as some can cope with the climate conditions. Yes, living in the chilly UK does have some benefits. Or if they can survive, they have limited impact if they establish in the wild. These are called non-native species. Invasive species make up around 10 to 15% of non-native species. And the key difference is that they can reproduce and spread rapidly in the environment, resulting in negative consequences. The reason for this is these species are introduced into an area which does not contain their natural predators to keep them in check. So their population expands very rapidly. Outcompeting or predating on native species that have not evolved strategies to survive alongside these new species. Some examples of invasive non-native species which you may have come across include American signal crayfish. This is a highly aggressive species which predates on insects and fish. And in addition to outcompeting native white-clawed crayfish, it also carries a disease that kills it. Another example is floating pennywort. This freshwater plant can grow up to 20 centimetres a day, so 1 metre per strand every 5 days, resulting in thick plant mats which completely cover and choke the water surface. This prevents light from reaching the water, causing the loss of habitat beneath these mats, which with knock-on decreases in shelter and food for insects and young fish. One small fragment of the plant can be washed downstream and grow into another mat. Invasive species can be found anywhere whilst you are on the bank. They could be in plants you brush past on the way to the water or growing at the water's edge. They could also be present in the water itself, lurking beneath the surface. Many anglers have suffered from signal crayfish taking their baits. They can be accidentally introduced through a variety of ways, but a key one is that they can be accidentally moved on equipment and clothing. Despite living in the water, plants and insects such as shrimps and small crayfish can survive for up to 14 days within damp nets or boots. This means that if you travel between two different water bodies, your equipment may have accidentally picked up some plant material, insect disease or fish fry at one site and then unintentionally released into the new water when you use your nets and boots at the next site. Invasive non-native species have devastating impacts on freshwater and marine environments. They can result in a decrease of fish health, loss of fish stock, and in some cases, such as the invasive fish, the topmouth gudgeon, can result in the fishery being shut down. To stop invasive non-native species and diseases such as KHV being spread between waters, there are 3 really simple but very effective steps that you can take after every trip. These are check, clean, and dry. Check. When you have finished fishing, check your equipment and boots and remove any plant material and mud that you can see and leave it at the water. Clean. Something such as plant seeds, diseases or insects can be very hard to see by eye. Therefore, always thoroughly clean your equipment and boots. Ideally, use hot water if you can. Dry. For the final step, dry your equipment in direct sunlight, ideally for 48 hours. This will kill off anything that still remains on your nets and boots and will also kill off diseases. These are such simple measures, but they do make such a difference.